Live from Atlanta, Georgia, it's At Home with AJ. And now, your host, Anthony S. and Jasmine.
Good evening. Hey, how's everybody doing? It's been a minute. Mm-hmm. It's been a minute. We were on vacation, taking a little time off. Jasmine and myself, and little Andy, we decided to take some time off. We drove down to, we've seen some family members and kind of just drove around, just took some time, so we deserve it. We worked hard, mm-hmm. took a little time off.
The summer's coming. It's that time.
We talked to some people about little Andy, so we're getting ready to roll on little Andy, his book, so we just needed that time. So we missed you guys, but we're back. We got a great show for you tonight, y'all.
Mm-hmm. Yes. So everybody, welcome to our home. This is At Home with AJ.
My name is Anthony. Yes.
Uh-huh, and I am Jasmine.
And little Anthony.
Oh, man. If so, we're back and we have some good news, don't we?
We sure do. We all know who the DeBarge family is. You remember the DeBarge?
Mm-hmm.
Okay? All that love and all this.
Yeah.
Well, their sister. I didn't know Bunny worked, I didn't know that she wrote as much as I've heard.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, she wrote most of the songs for the DeBarge.
A lot of the songs.
Family.
And Elle may have sang those songs, All This Love. But Bunny, from what I understand, was a major force.
Oh yeah, she and one of the older brothers did a lot of the writing for that group.
They did some work with Switch as well, as that's their older brothers.
They're cousins. And
well, they had two brothers in Switch.
The family is just crazy talented.
I think Bobby was in Switch, and they had another brother in Switch.
Mm-hmm.
And she actually wrote for them too.
Yeah.
But as for what we've been told right now, Bunny is getting ready to come out and do her own thing.
Mm-hmm.
Musgrove Distribution signs Motown legend Bunny DeBarge to a huge mega deal.
Mm-hmm.
So we're talking big.
Hey, I'm happy for her.
There's no need to talk about her history because Bunny DeBarge is the sister of DeBarge. She's the that beautiful looking lady that was there. What's that song?
Ooh, ooh, child. Come on.
No.
Oh, you know what I'm thinking about?
You're thinking of Stair Steps.
Stair Steps. Not the DeBarge.
You're thinking of Stair Steps.
The brother did most of the songs. Bunny really didn't do a lot of leads.
Bunny wrote a lot of the songs. All This Love, all them hits they had, Bunny had a part in writing a lot of those songs.
Yeah.
Okay. Now she's getting ready to come out with her own thing. So I'm wondering, how does that, what's she going to come out with?
I don't know, but I'm just happy for her, at this time in her life to reinvent herself.
We miss them.
We
miss her.
And get it going again. We miss the music, so that's going to be some real music coming back, some real singing, because the DeBarge family had the harmony of life.
When they came on the scene, they changed the landscape of harmony.
Oh, my goodness.
When Switch was out, because Switch was out before them, okay,
mm-hmm.
that's what Bobby... One of the older brothers.
Yeah.
Okay. And you can kind of hear that DeBarge sound because Bobby brought that sound to Switch.
Right.
Bobby and the trumpet player actually were the leaders of Switch.
Yeah. We had those. It's so easy to get so confused because there was families were out back then. You had the Jacksons. You had the DeBarge. You had the Stair Steps.
Mm-hmm.
You had the Partridge Family. You had the Osmonds.
Yeah.
All these families were out. Yeah. And then the Jacksons, right?
Right. So Bunny is look out for Bunny. Bunny DeBarge is coming your way, everybody, and I can't wait.
Me neither.
I hope she brings some of the brothers with her.
You know what? She just might.
I mean,
she just might.
Because we're going to be looking for that.
Mm-hmm.
Bunny is out. Bunny, where's the brothers? Where's the boss? Where's Mel? You know.
Hey,
so
it might be something to get them all started again.
Yeah. And if not, hey, Bonnie, we're happy for you. Do your thing.
Mm-hmm.
You know. Yes, I am so glad
that
one of them is coming back out.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
And so, babe, do you have any shout outs to anybody?
I do. I want to shout out to a family member of mine, my brother Aaron Smith. Been meaning to give you a call lately. I'm going to be calling you more often. But I want to shout out to my brother Aaron Smith. He's my younger brother, okay, up there in New York, in Queens, and he's up in Hollis. So I want to shout out to Aaron Douglas Smith, my brother. Love you, brother. I'll be talking to you soon.
Yay.
Aaron Smith, hope you've been watching the shows. But we love you, man. Also want to shout out to one more family member, mm-hmm. my dad. Got you, Dad.
Hey,
see?
Dad.
Leroy Smith. For those of you who do not know this, but I have his middle name, Leroy. So when you see Anthony L. Smith, that L means Leroy.
All right.
Did you know that?
I did.
Okay.
I did.
Anthony L. Smith, Leroy Smith, shouting out to my father, Leroy Smith. Love you, Dad. I'll be talking to you soon. Got a birthday
see you
coming
soon.
Up. Birthday coming up.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Leo.
I'll Leo's in the house.
Okay.
Leo the lion.
Okay.
I have a shout out, babe. I'm going to shout out
to
Morris Baxter.
Shout out to me.
Always shout out to you,
shout
Anthony.
Out to me. Okay. I'm just playing.
But this shout out is going out to Morris Baxter of WCLK.
Okay, Morris, my man. Yes.
He will be hosting Friday nights at St. James Live. So you guys make sure you get out there on a Friday night and check him out, see what he's doing. I know they have a lot of different guests coming through there. Mm-hmm. It's a very nice club. Let me see if they have the address on here.
They're in Buckner Road.
Buckner Road, that's right. Buckner Road.
Right off of Cam Creek.
Next to the cigar bar, right?
Go west on Cam Creek to Buckner Road, make a left.
Mm-hmm.
It's right there. Can't miss it.
Yeah, so check him out. Yep. Go out there, shout out to Morris and the WCLK family, Miss Reva Blue.
Reva.
I'm shouting out to you, lady.
We'll see Reva at the Summer Jams, I'm pretty sure.
Oh, yeah, the Summer Jams.
Speaking of Summer Jams, that's coming up, y'all. Summer Jams is coming up June the 12th.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Summer Jams right here. Bring your axe. Bring your guitar. Bring your sax. You know, I'm going to be blowing. I told you, you saw me in the Christmas show. You're going to see me blowing here at Summer Jams, okay? So bring your axe, bring your drums, bring your guitar, bring it.
Mm-hmm.
Summer Jam, bring your blanket, bring your lawn chairs. BYOBB, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we got you covered on the food. Bring your own drinks, okay? You know, I'm gonna have mine.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm gonna bring.
Okay. And also don't forget about the Comedy Explosion, Red Fox Meets Mom's
Maybelline.
Sunday, September 4th. Please get your tickets now. Tickets are on sale. Go to eventbrite.com and get your tickets.
Get them now.
Every month we will have 1 week where we will be selling the tickets 2 for 1. Well, you buy 2, get 1 free.
Right.
Okay, for 1 week each month up until August. And that's when that will stop, that promotion will stop. So get your tickets now. It's going to be a lot of fun. We can't wait. We're excited. And that's going to be the first in a series of dinner theater shows that we will be hosting.
And also, don't forget, you people that's in business. If you have a business, you can also advertise mm-hmm. your business in our playbill. All right? So
mm-hmm.
It's posted online. It's posted on Facebook how you can actually be a sponsor and sponsor a $5 spot, okay, or a full page. There's a lot of folks out there that does have businesses. Or they work for somebody, or they have their own business,
mm-hmm.
and you can put that ad in our playbill. Parking spot.
Yeah, well, as a sponsor, what we want you to do is to buy a ticket. If you buy a ticket and you can't make it, we will be giving some tickets away. We're going to be doing some radio spots
mm-hmm.
and giving some tickets away. And if you decide that you want to donate a ticket or two, that's all open.
That's right.
We appreciate it all.
You can sponsor one ticket. You can sponsor
Tickets or a table.
Or a table. A table,
table
is
of eight.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
We picked up our first corporate sponsor.
Yes, sir.
You know that? Parking Spot, shout out to Parking Spot, their first corporate sponsor. Thank you very much, Parking Spot, for coming in. They got a full page ad.
Yes.
Full page.
Thank you.
Thank you, Parking Spot. Mm-hmm. So we hope to get a lot more of sponsors and also ads for our playbill. So y'all come on in with your business, come on in and do it. Make it happen.
And you know what, babe? I have another shout out. I want to shout out to the GMIA, Georgia Music Industry Association. Please, you guys, look them up, Google them, the Georgia Music Industry. Mm-hmm. It's a great organization. They are putting together a lot of great events coming up. I want you, like I said, Google them, look them up, and get involved. All you musicians, entertainers out there, you know, I'm sure there's something for you to do in there. Once you become a member, membership is free. Once you become a member, the seminars, everything is free. And it's great information. I went to one of the meetings and I joined. They have a lot of information on recording and songwriting and copyrights, you know, laws. So please get involved, become a member. Well, tonight we have another great show. This lady, this is a beautiful lady, and she is a blues singer.
I love blues singers.
Yeah,
love them, blues singers.
She is not playing.
I heard she's one of the best out there.
She is awesome.
Yeah, she hopefully will be at our summer jams coming up.
Most definitely.
You know, a lot of folks are going to be coming. You got to come to summer. I'm telling you, summer jams is going to be the place to be at. So, you want to bring her on?
Everybody, please. Put your hands together for the beautiful,
the fabulous,
Ms. Rebekah Easley. Hi. Oh, my God.
Girl. Welcome.
Hi. Well, come on. You sit right in the middle.
Where that gold pillow is, right there.
I feel underdressed.
Oh girl, stop.
You look great. You look great.
Hey, listen.
You know who that is.
You know who this is, right?
I do.
And you know what you have to do. You have to feel this.
There you go. Yeah. You see? That's you gotta do
he
that.
Loves it.
You gotta do that. Hey, what's up, man?
I think Anna's come home with me.
We'll talk.
Okay.
I'll bring him back.
I know you've been biting. I know you said, who is that? And I said, she's one of our guests. She's an artist. You know. You didn't know that Anthony had a little girlfriend that came on last week.
You know, I heard about this girl. Right?
You know, yeah. She couldn't stay.
Yeah, she just came for a visit.
Wait, was she cute enough?
She was.
She was hot.
No, come on now. Anthony's dad was like,
No, she was.
He could do better.
You know, they didn't have a lot of time to talk, but they, you know, they kind of got
vibed a little bit.
They vibed something. You know, okay, they had little bad stories to talk about. Mm-hmm.
Was she a musician bear?
Was she? I don't know.
No, she wasn't a musician bear.
No, that's like a workout.
But, you know, he got a number.
That's a good start.
He got a number.
Hey, first love.
He got a number. So, you know, he going to holler at her. He going to holler.
Any pound. Go Anthony. Here you go.
He going to holler at her.
His hands are a little tight.
That's cool. He's still pounding.
Yeah,
they're like in permanent pound position.
He said, if my hands ain't tied, girl, what
can
I do?
He's like, I just ain't got no fucking pounds.
You know, he's working on a book deal now, so we're trying to get that book deal. He got his Facebook page now.
I did not know
he
that.
Got his own.
Can I be
Facebook.
Your friend?
Yes.
Of course, Ms.
He's got
Easley.
His Facebook page came out in January.
Say what?
Yes, for real.
Okay.
For real.
Okay, now.
So, got more in order than to I be do. His friend, no, now, Ms. Easley, do you live here in Georgia?
I do. I live in Atlanta, in South Atlanta, in what they call. The SWAT.
Oh, you live in the SWATs?
I do.
Tell us what the SWATs.
Yeah.
What is the SWATs?
Oh, my.
Because, we're Northerners.
Yeah. Fill us in. We don't know.
Let's see. All the, like, T.I., I believe. Now, T.I.
Really?
Is probably going like.
Lives around there? Around the corner?
Like, don't put me down from the SWATs. But I live Southwest Atlanta, right?
Mm-hmm.
So
Southwest.
That's
Like East Point.
Above East Point.
Above East Point.
But below 20.
Gotcha.
So like that little quadrant over there.
I got you. I know where you are.
Where, you know, you watch the news and it's all crime.
No.
When they're like,
here we are, back in the same area.
Like, there were 3 murders today. And it was in the Southwest Atlanta. I'm like, oh, okay, great.
I don't think it's like that.
But a lot of great people come out of the
SWAT. I mean, you know, right. Right. I guess they're street smart by the time we
get going somewhere.
Oh, God.
But. So, Rebekah, were you born there? Were you born here?
No, actually, I'm from New Jersey.
Oh, Jersey.
Get out. Woo, woo, woo. Shout out to Jersey.
Because you know we all end up moving down here.
What part of Jersey?
Yeah.
Bergen County. I was born in Englewood Hospital, and then we moved to Hackensack.
Okay. I went to school in Hackensack.
Okay.
Thank you.
And then when I was in third grade, and we moved to a town called Ridgewood.
Yeah.
Which was just a bedroom community.
I don't know nothing of Jersey. I lived there 3 years.
You were like, what is that?
Hey, we here. I'm New York.
In the early 90s. No, but I used to live in Jersey City for like 3 years.
Yeah. Okay. But city. That's still living in... Like, we walked to school in the snow and stuff.
Yeah,
like,
I didn't grow up there. I grew up in Queens.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. See, the boroughs, I still don't get how that works. I have to, like...
Brooklyn, Bronx, Manhattan, Staten Island.
Oh, yeah, I don't get that either.
You know what I mean? And they're like, if I'm writing a letter, do I put Bronx?
Bronx on it, or
you know what I mean?
New York.
Well,
you gotta put
I think it's BX for Bronx.
And if so you do put the borough.
You put something New York.
It's like it's Queens, like an New York thing. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Sometimes you don't have to. You just put just New York. You know.
Yeah, that's all.
Because they'll go by the zip code. They're gonna go by the zip code anyway.
I don't care actually what you write.
They're gonna go by the zip code anyway. So you can be West Hill, New York, and then, the zip code is so.
You're dressed in the zip code, it'll get there.
So it'll get there
with postage.
Yeah.
So you grew up in Jersey. So when did you come to Georgia?
My family moved down here. Actually, we did a detour in Alabama for a year, but we moved down when I was ninth grade. I just finished ninth grade, and we moved down to Alabama, which is where my mom's family is from. That was a culture shock.
I'm from Jersey.
I had 5 wives.
Oh, yeah. Mobile? What part?
It was Opelika, so it's only like an hour and a half from here.
Okay.
It's, you know, 85 or whatever. But yeah, so that was a culture shock. Okay. And it was easy for me, but like my little sister, I have 3 sisters, and the 2 younger ones just had like, it was a hard transition.
Oh my goodness.
You know, I'm talking about dirt road. I'm talking about if it rained, you maybe couldn't get to school. Because the bus was like down the river. You know what I mean?
Oh my
essentially.
Gosh.
It was really interesting. I'm glad, you know, as an adult, I'm really glad for the experience.
Mm-hmm.
But at the time, we were just like, what is going on? But,
so you have 3 sisters. Any brothers?
0.
Okay, so,
I cannot relate to men.
4 ladies. Mm-hmm. You can't relate to men.
That leads me to one of my Ask AJ questions.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, you have some Ask AJ questions.
Do.
Look. She's going to pick our brain.
Y'all tell me. I'm coming. I'm like,
our fans
I got my post-it notes.
We got a lot of fans. They write in and pick our brain, and hopefully we can, you know, answer their questions.
Well, she brought some herself.
I did.
Me and Jazz.
Okay, go ahead.
Let me know.
Okay, hit us.
Is it to both of us or to one of us?
It's to both of you. You know what? That would be really cool to get. And I'm going to get hers first.
This is the
first.
No,
I want it yours.
This is the first now. Okay. This is the first time this has happened that a guest is actually going to ask us AJ questions. This is cool.
Okay, that's good. Okay, so here's my first question, which
does
has nothing to do with music.
No.
Okay. I don't know. He's got a girlfriend.
She wants you to answer first.
He's advanced.
Oh, this is to me.
I'm going to ask you first, and then I want her perspective, right?
Hold on.
Yes, this is like a double.
Okay.
My question right.
I'm right now.
You ready?
Look at Bobby over there laughing. Okay.
Okay. I'm a single woman.
Yes.
I've been single for quite some time.
Boy, this sounds like a real ass game. Not-
Look, if you take romance questions, I was like, wait a minute now.
Yes, we do.
Let me bring my question.
We take them.
Okay, so I'm a single woman. I'm not necessarily the most refined woman there is out there, but I'm happy. Like, you know, I don't get my nails done or whatever, but
okay.
I don't get my nails done.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So, okay. So, me, just imagine like a log cabin and there's Rebekah. Okay. Where am I supposed to go to find men that can have conversations? And, you know, like I have a question about that because I'm 42.
Okay, I'm
going
to zip it up. I'm going to be there's quiet. Yeah, you hold. Okay.
But from a man's perspective, mm-hmm. to meet somebody like me, okay. where would you expect to meet me at?
And you said you just revealed that you were 42.
I am. Okay,
so
yeah.
You're not, you know, you're a child.
32. Let's say 32. Okay, 32. Okay.
It's too late.
You put it out there.
Let's say 32.
You are what you are. Okay. Yo, mature woman. Silly.
I'm open minded.
Where do you expect to meet mature men that have some conversation?
But are still interesting and fun and can go to shows and not be like, oh, it's late. You know what I mean?
Church.
Okay, hold.
Okay, I'm holding.
Church.
You know why I say that? So you think I'm kidding.
I don't think you're kidding.
I'm serious. Church.
Aren't you quiet most of the time
there
in church?
There are, but there are a lot of men who do go to church.
Single.
Sure, they do. Yes.
But don't they notice the
The answer that you probably wanted.
Ladies with their nails done and stuff.
A lot of ladies go to church. A lot of ladies who care about themselves, like my lady here.
Exactly.
They go to church very well together.
Yes.
And you, a lot of men will go to church, not just for that. I mean, of course, hopefully they're going for the, you know, to hear the word.
Like the religion,
yeah. But I can tell you one thing. See, you didn't expect that answer. But I tell you one thing. Knowing that there is a lot of nice looking women who care about themselves, okay? I'm pretty sure that they will find a nice looking lady, refined, well put together in church. You can find a woman anywhere, but the kind of woman that a man would look for, a man who really cares mm-hmm. about having a nice, refined, respectable woman.
Well, but I'm not refined. It's like, she could just go sit on the porch and men would be coming up to you.
I didn't want to say, well, the average bar or the average.
Is it my turn yet?
I'm serious. I could have said the average bar or the average club or whatever. No, church.
But see, my challenge is I'm not.
Are you with a church?
I'm not even going to say well put together because I think that.
No, babe. Can I go?
Wait. Do you understand what I'm saying? Wait, no, but see, this is a good thing.
When you're saying you're not put together, I'm just trying to get the facts. What do you mean by you're not put together?
Give me your hands.
Mentally.
You have to listen to what she's saying.
Listen to me.
Okay, so she doesn't have her nails done. Okay, I understand.
But
goes beyond that.
Of course it does. This is just an example. Like, I think, okay, now I may be jaded, and this may be getting off topic, but I do feel like men are more attracted to people who are pretty and, like, jewelry and put together and nails and stuff.
Can I go?
But somebody that's rustic.
Okay. Can I go now?
Yeah, I said. Well,
are you done?
You say I should go to church?
I said there were some fine men, let's say if I was single, fine men in church that got it together.
You would not be looking for me in church.
See, okay, can I go?
You would not be. You would not be. You would come. You would,
never know.
And if we were thrown together somehow,
you never
your,
know.
Your outfits are better than my outfits.
You never
you know.
Know
what I'm saying? So, like,
he may not be looking for all
work.
That.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Is it my turn?
Okay, yes.
It's your turn.
Okay.
Go ahead, my turn.
Lay some knowledge on
okay.
me.
Go ahead, my turn.
Because time is running out.
I know. Now Rebekah says, now you have to listen to what she says. She says she's not into the frilly thing. She doesn't do the nails thing. She doesn't, mm-hmm. she's.
Okay.
So what she wants to know is, where are the men that will go for the type of woman that she sees herself to be?
What do you think they are?
Okay. I say that they are everywhere. That type of man, there are a lot of men out there that don't like makeup, women that wear makeup. You'd be surprised.
Where are they at?
They could be in the field. You could be pumping gas, all of a sudden
yeah,
you meet a guy.
You could be pumping gas, you could be in the grocery store.
It could be anywhere, really.
It could be,
it really could be anywhere.
They are all over.
I mean, that's happened, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and here's my thing. When I first moved to Georgia, mm-hmm. I did dating sites.
I'm really on all did. Of the dating sites.
Are you really? Yeah. And you have to be honest. You have to be truthful and tell them, you know, I don't wear a lot of makeup. I don't do nails. I'm not the frilly girl.
Right.
You know, be honest. And you will get the kind of guy that you're talking about, you know?
Yeah.
Because a lot of guys say women go on there and they trick them. You know, they say they're one way and they're no, another
that's
way.
That's not me. I'm okay. not capable of tricking.
So you do it's that. Be yourself.
Yeah.
Be yourself. Mm-hmm. Be honest. And that person will come.
And, you know, I said church, but mm-hmm. basically it could be anywhere. Like I said, you could be at the gas station pumping gas and all of a sudden you see somebody coming out of QT and say, mm-hmm. You never know. You could be in the store. You could be in Walmart, walk past.
Right.
You could be mm-hmm. anywhere.
So I don't have to convert into something that I can't.
Right.
You don't
no.
have to.
Like, no. If you're not the nail type
I'm
of person,
not frilly, yeah.
and you know, and all the other stuff, all the frilly stuff, no. And plus, you're an artist. Don't you know that besides being you, your beautiful self, you're an artist. You have that's attracting enough to
right.
a lot of people that, you know.
Right.
They want to get to know you. How do you do that? What? How do you get up on that stage and do what you do? You know? That really?
No, that sounds great. Yeah.
Yeah. That.
A lot of men would be turned on by that.
Yeah.
You're an artist. Wow. Are you saying?
It does. Nice. It takes a lot of guts to get up and in front of a lot of people and sing. You know.
Sing well too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. There you go.
And you both. Do that very well.
Thank you. But we're talking about you.
ladies and gentlemen, we have, you know, the staff is just cracking us up out there. So, you know, when we met.
Yes,
please tell me that.
We did not expect that to happen. We didn't expect it to happen.
Wait.
It just clicked. It just happened.
Was it at church?
We were at the, no, it wasn't.
It was not at church.
It was not at
was
church.
Was it at the gas station?
That's no, right. Not at the gas station. Okay. We met through a mutual friend. Okay, she actually.
But music brought us together.
Yeah, music brought us together.
It was because of music.
I was backing up a major artist here in Atlanta, and we needed to replace the girl that we had with somebody else, and that somebody else was Jasmine. So he brought her in, and
you
I met her.
And yeah,
and
that's how we met.
That's
but I want to ask you something. Have you tried to meet guys that were into music? Because I'm sure that's all you. That's, you're around them a lot, right? Musicians.
Right? Yes, yeah. I love musicians.
Yeah,
especially drummers.
Okay.
Hey, see,
everybody, this woman loves drummers.
You heard it first. Drummers,
uh-huh,
okay.
Uh-huh.
She's a nice looking lady.
You should have told me that, because I am going to start. I'm going to play matchmaker.
You just keep it right here.
Hey,
matchmaker.
I'm open.
Jasmine knows a lot of people.
Just don't send me somebody who has better shoes than me. You know what I'm saying?
And does he have to be a drummer?
Just wouldn't work. No, he
just,
doesn't have to be
an
anything.
Artist. Just an artist.
He just has to be smart and funny and.
Well, this lady is awesome.
Okay.
Do not take this from her. As a matter of fact, you're going to sing for us, right? Because
yes.
You can give us our other question when you come back.
Right.
I want
okay.
you to go and do what you do and mesmerize a drummer out there.
Ooh.
Uh-oh. So what's the first song you're going to do for us?
It's called I Can't Hold Out Much Longer. And it's actually a Little Walter song. Who's just one of the greats.
Oh, yes. Okay. Yes. And Little Walter, you guys, if you check out the movie Cadillac Records, you'll see a little bit of Little Walter in there. They talk about him a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Good guy.
Yeah.
And just amazing music. That
so, everybody, put your hands together for Ms. Rebekah Easley.
Yeah.
Come on, lady.
Yeah. Talk to him, girl.
You know I'm wild
about you, baby, by you. Don't care nothing in the world for me. Well, I can't sleep at night. I just can't nap through the day. I can't hold out much longer, baby, living this way. You know I'm crazy about you, baby. Wonder, do you ever think of me? You know I'm wild about you, honey, but you don't care nothing in the world for me. Oh, there ain't but one thing, honey, that'll make me go to drink. When you say that you don't love me, oh, I start to think you know you're crazy about me, baby. But I wonder, do you ever have a think of me? I'm wild about you, baby, but you don't care nothing in the world for me. I can't stand it when you always put me down. I put a spell on you. Oh, because you're mine. Oh, because you're mine. Oh, because you're mine, 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 mine. Oh.
Just get ready to leave us.
Beautiful. Man.
That was awesome.
Oh, thank you so much for wanting to do that.
Mm. I'm too big to get a load of this stuff. Oh, my gosh.
This is coming out next week, so they're going to see you. They're going to be like, oh, who is that? Everybody watches this show.
Look.
Okay. People Facebook. In Kenya are watching this show.
No, they really are.
That's pretty much.
No,
really, I have a friend in Nigeria. She has her own jazz club. She checks us out too.
Okay, a jazz club in Nigeria.
I'm telling you,
she used to live here in Georgia.
Oh wow! So she took the whole flavor down there.
She's gone. Yeah, but she checks the show out. So you never know.
You never do know.
So, Ms. Easley, what's that other question you have for us?
The other question I had was about music, because I've always been a singer in the house, you know what I'm saying? Like, music just sort of lights up my life and has consistently, probably since I was, you know, 7 or 8, I remember. Right. So coming into, especially the Atlanta area, where there are a ton of musicians with amazing talents, and just going to jams and trying to kind of get to know what it's like to be a performer, it's been a big challenge, especially because my personality is, I'm kind of a softie until I get mad, but.
Was that mean you have a kind spirit?
Yeah.
Okay.
I just wonder sometimes, like, I mean, I'm sure there are ideal makeups for doing this on a regular basis. And I just wonder, is there space for someone who is a little lighter than most? and just, you know, I think people just automatically think I'm, like, silly or whatever, but do I need to be, like, a hard ass to be able to?
Oh, you mean, like, as a band leader? Or just as a vocalist in general, fronting a band?
Yeah, I guess all of the above. You know, just what do you guys think on what are the keys to success as far as like getting what you are passionate about out of your activity, but also being able to do it with other people successfully without being like, oh, I wish, you know.
Mm-hmm. No, the first thing is knowing what you want.
Right.
Okay, let's say you are getting ready to do a show with a band. Okay, you pick your musicians, right? You're picking your musicians, so you know who you want to play for you.
Yeah,
and so, I've
been very spoiled.
So you pretty much know them. So the next thing is knowing what you want. You know, you got your songs, you know what songs you want. The next thing is knowing that you are paying these guys. So you have the right to ask for a rehearsal.
Yep.
You know, me myself, I always try to get at least one rehearsal before the show.
Yeah.
At least one. Give me one rehearsal, one good rehearsal before the show.
That makes sense.
You know, and like I said, you have to know what you want in each one of those songs that you're doing, how you want to do it. You know, when you want to end it with solos, who's going to take a solo? Everybody can, if it's, you know, or you want one person to take a solo and that's it.
Right.
You have to let them know about that.
In other words, you have to be in charge. You have to let them know that you are in charge without being a bully.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say.
You know
who you're dealing with. So you know you don't have to be a hard ass.
Yeah.
You know?
If I'm hiring just like you said, you know, if I'm hiring a pianist, a drummer, keyboard player, I'm going to hire people that I feel that can do what I want. They can give me the sound that I want, number one. That's number one. I'm only going to pick the people that I actually like, that I feel that I won't have any problems with. Their heads are not too far up there where they can't be told something.
Right.
A lot of musicians have a lot of egos, and it's like you have problems, sometimes you have problems with certain people. But I'm going to try to get people who are on the same page with me, okay?
Right.
That I could actually say, hey, this is how I want it. This is the style that I'm looking for. Mm-hmm. This is the tempo that I want it on. You know what I'm saying? And I'm going to, you're going to play a solo in that one, and or no solos in this song.
Right. Exactly. Order, and people probably like that structure to know what
you have to always be in charge. This is your gig.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Because to tell you the truth, a lot of musicians want you to do that.
Right. Like they want to know what you're looking for.
Yeah. And if you go in not knowing what you want, they're going to feel that. They're going to pick up on that.
They're going to eat you alive.
And they're going to eat you alive.
Okay. So yeah, that's
you're hiring them. So you're in charge. You're paying them. They're going to know how much they're getting paid. Okay. You're the boss. But also try to be, you know, on their page too. Don't make it feel so uncomfortable. Like, hey, we can't make a move, you know.
Well, that's the thing is because you guys, I mean, I'm asking because you guys have a really, you guys are pros and super talented, but you're also musicians in other ways, you know. Like, I am just a singer, so.
Oh, no.
Well,
I'm sorry. Just a singer. You
I don't play instruments.
See, neither do I. Your voice is your instrument. I was going to say, yeah, don't say that you're just a singer. I used to do that. Anthony used to get on me all the time.
No,
your voice is your instrument. And it's just as important as his saxophone, as his drums, his keys. It's just as important. Or more because you're fronting the band.
Do you feel like you have to be perfect, though?
Nope.
Like, how do you?
Nobody's perfect.
No one's perfect.
Nobody's perfect.
Okay. No,
you're going to make some blunders. You're going to get up there. You're going to get up there and forget words. You're going to get up there and sing the wrong words in the wrong place.
And you know what's
good
about
that's the best thing about blues, though.
But you know what's good about falling on your face is getting back up.
Being able to get back
up. Being able to get back
up. Knowing how to recover
from that word or from that.
That's
I forgot that sentence. And just improvise.
Shoot, sometimes that's better than the show.
Yeah.
You know, when knowing how to recover from a mess up.
Right.
That's real.
Because
good.
You see, I've been to shows where I've actually seen, I mean, big time artists forget their lyrics. Mm-hmm. This is their song now. But you know, the audience is singing their song.
Let me tell you, I was on a show one time where this guy was singing and he fell off the stage. And had the mic in his hand and kept singing.
He played it. That was a good one. So he was like this on his back.
And, I mean, he said he fell right off the stage and kept the mic in his hand. And kept
now, that's a singer.
That is.
I mean, you know.
So things happen. So you have to just know yourself, know what you want, be in control, be confident.
Yeah.
That's all.
And there may be times. Now, if you have musicians that. just want to take over. You know, you have some musicians that do that too. They come into a situation and they just run.
And they telling you what to do.
That
will never happen.
No.
Well, see, there you go.
It won't happen twice.
No.
But
you're paying
I'm
them.
I'm bubbly, but come on now.
No, you're paying them. So they have to do, they should do.
So see, so you're not, so you know you.
I do. And you know what? I bet you it's, I mean, I'm just generally a sweet person.
Mm-hmm.
I have my opinions in the back of my mind, but especially in the music context, because I get to play with so many super talented people at the jams that I go to, like, I'm just very spoiled, and knowing that they're all of that, and I'm sitting here like, okay, with the microphone,
but the thing
it's a different
is that
mindset. So you just have a lot of respect for those people.
I'm intimidated by that.
Don't be intimidated.
They don't know how serious or how strong or how you are, too. They don't know where you're coming from. So they could be intimidated. Like,
that's a big black one right there.
So you don't know.
When you were singing those songs, I felt felt all of that. You know, the strength. Yeah, yeah.
I was sitting there saying, man, she's got a great sound. Oh my gosh. She reminds me of somebody. I'm not going to say it, but she reminds me of a major artist that I've heard before.
Yeah.
There you go.
And the stage presence and everything. I mean, I love it. I think it's great.
Oh, thank you.
I have a question for you, Rebekah. At what age? We don't go back now. At what age, mm-hmm. let's say, did you know that you had a voice?
Yeah.
That you knew that you can sing a little bit. Mm-hmm. You know, at what age did you recognize that you had that something that could be that could turn out to be something? Mm-hmm. At what age were you serious about it? Now, of course, you know, a lot of folks started. I started singing at 4 or 5 years old. But when did you recognize that you had a voice
that I could share? I will say, I remember being in high school, and it was here in Georgia, so I was 11th grade, I guess. And
I expected earlier, but you said 11th grade.
Look, I'll sing to myself and think it sounds good, but I mean, I have no gauge, right? Like, no one's really listening to me. But what happened in 11th grade was, in high school, in the 80s and 90s, you know, people would get together at lunchtime and do beatboxing, and like everybody had a little rap or whatever.
Right.
And I would always just be the girl off to the side, just, you know, like, okay. Mm-hmm.
And
then
one
day I was like, okay, well, you know, but then I was so quiet. And like nobody was trying to hear that, you know what I mean? Like everybody was like, "Okay, you sound really nice, but we can't hear you." And I was just a really shy person for forever, right? So I always thought that I could do it if lightning struck, and if I was like X-Men or something. I don't know. I just was like, okay, well, if I could just like swap out my personality, I would be like a really good singer, right?
So did you get a shot one day when opportunity came to you that you? Take that shot. Somebody asked you to sing at a gig. Your first real place performance.
Well, it's an interesting path because that happened, like I said, in '89, right? '90,
and then. Well, did you do choirs before that?
I did do so like school choirs and things, but never like solos or anything that required a little extra. Mm-hmm. But I mean, I love music, but then after I don't even know what decade it was.
I'm so old.
But there was an era where I would go to a Apache Cafe all the time. Like, somebody brought me there for, like, a spoken word.
Right.
And I was like, wait a minute now. Monday there's something different, and Tuesday there's something different. Mm-hmm.
Gotcha.
So I was there and just got to hear people making just amazing music. And I was just observing, like, the whole time. Like, I went there for years.
Okay.
And nobody that goes there would be able to tell you that.
Before you actually
sing. Nobody would ever know.
I used to go to Apache when they did jazz, when they were Yin Yangs.
Yeah, oh my God, yes.
Nice. So you started going to Apache too. They did a lot of neo soul.
Right.
And stuff.
So I would just sit in the, you know. But that was when I was like, okay, so people can do this, and it doesn't have to be a job. Like, it doesn't have to be rap. It can be just regular people getting up on an open mic night.
Right.
And sharing, and everybody's supportive or whatever. So it kind of put that in my mind. And then a few years ago, I was in Chicago for a medical conference. I'm not a doctor, but I work with some. Anyway, I was in Chicago, and we went to just find some music, and we went to Buddy Guy's.
Buddy Guy's, okay.
We just kind of stumbled in there, and I was mesmerized. Like, there was some old man, you know, sweaty with the cowboy hat on up there, like, with just, I believe he had a guitar that was made
singing
out of some
blues.
Other equipment. Like, it was like, I won't say cigar box, but it was rustic. And yeah, it was the storytelling and the fact that it was all pure emotion, you know what I mean? But without being
was
dramatic.
It was like folk music, like folksy or
it was just
straight
up old blues.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, just straight up, you know, my daddy left me when I was, you know. And everybody was just like, and I'm sitting there going, and I remember saying to the girl that I was with, I was like, oh my God, I want to sing blues.
Because that was the moment.
Because come on now, like, it's an easy format. I was like, I just got to repeat the same line.
In the
like
blues, you can tell your story.
Tell your story.
About yourself or about somebody
right.
else.
Yeah. And the structure, I mean, there's a ton of structures, right? But it's built so that it's repetitive a little bit, and it's like you can kind of ease up to it. You know mm-hmm. what I mean? It's just got a great feel for, like, the story. So that was the spark. Mm-hmm. But then when I came back home, I just basically wanted to find blues bands mm-hmm. to go listen to. And I'd happened to go out on an internet date.
There you go.
And that person told me about a band mm-hmm. that played the blues in Atlanta. So, and they had a jam. So I went up there, and a few months ago, I looked up like the actual instant message that I had sent him, where I was mm-hmm. like, "Hey, remember that band you told me about? Like,
mm-hmm. who was it? Do you remember?"
The band's called the Casanovas.
Oh,
and they are.
Jazz, you know?
I heard of them. Casanovas.
They're my favorite. But they host a jam every week at Darwin.
Isn't that the band that we saw, and they were like all over YouTube or something? They got a lot of stuff on YouTube.
Oh,
the Casanovas.
It's blues, but it's Casanovas with a Z. But okay. they hosted the jam, mm-hmm. and I went up there one day. And for about a year, I just kind of lurked, you know?
And like, you didn't sing?
I support all local music. Look, so I'll be
drinking.
So laughing.
In a year, you was hiding in the shadow, just observing. Mm-hmm.
So did a friend get you up there, dare you to go up, or did you go on your own?
Because all of the stuff I've done solo, right?
So like, were you by yourself that night?
By myself. Okay. Leave when I, you know, feel like leaving.
Did you plan on singing that night? Did you know you was going
to
sing?
No, but somebody, I wanted to, but I'd wanted to a lot of nights, you know?
Right.
And if I'm not mistaken, I could be wrong, but I think it was Mojo. I got my mojo working. Mm-hmm. And I mean, come on now, you kind of learn that song in school. So I think it was that, but somebody told me like, oh no, just get up there and like, you know, mm-hmm. I was probably singing in my chair or whatever at the bar, and they were mm-hmm. like, look, just go up there. Nobody's gonna like boo you or throw tomatoes at you or whatever. And so I did, but it's been just such a journey from there to here, because I'm telling you, I was still the really quiet, like, wait a minute now.
No, I can't believe that.
But, you know,
Do you remember the song you did?
I think it was I Got My Mojo Working.
Okay.
And, like, my sister gets so mad if I sing that song nowadays.
Why?
She's like, that's cheating. It's like, you sing that song all the time. But it's just such
that's
a...
good.
It makes you feel good.
Every singer has one song that they sing.
They can
all
sing
the time.
In their sleep.
That's their go-to song. Yeah, yeah.
Well, man, Muddy Waters, I saw this live recording of him from 1960, mm-hmm. where he was at some jazz fest.
Muddy Waters.
That man. Wow. You look at him and he's just swaggering. Just like, I don't even think he opened his eyes the whole time. And I'm just like, okay. Muddy. You know what I mean? Like, just... sing it.
Got my mojo.
So that song.
You seen the movie Cadillac Records.
I haven't
you'll
seen
see.
That.
Oh,
you have
see
it?
That. Oh,
no.
You can see that movie. Then you Come get to see the person now. Playing Muddy Waters. It was a great movie.
Yeah.
And Little Milton. And
like I said, Little Walter. Yeah.
And Etta James.
Etta James. Yeah. Yeah.
You know, she's amazing. So.
Beyonce played her part, I believe, right?
Mm-hmm.
Did she do all right?
She did okay.
Okay. She was good.
Cool.
Yeah.
No, I have to see that movie. But anyway, I guess I'm just grateful that I'm here right now, because a lot of my stuff has just been, you know, it's jammy, it's opportunity, and mm-hmm. you get up there and you try
well,
to
being,
go for it or whatever.
Being here is part of your journey.
I know.
It's
yeah.
part of your journey.
That's
okay.
why I really appreciate you guys.
We heard about you. We heard about you. We wanted you to come on the show.
I was like, oh my God.
Jazz has heard you. She told me.
My sister
and, you know,
was like, hey, I know someone. I'm like, hey.
Yeah. And like I said, this is part of your journey. There's going to be a lot more mm-hmm. of this.
So are you singing anywhere around here? You want to tell everybody if you're going to be performing anywhere?
Normally, I just perform at the Casanovas Blues Jam on Wednesday nights.
And where's that?
It's at Darwin's in Marietta.
Yes. Okay.
It's on Roswell Road.
Okay.
And that's generally, that's my forum right now. And I have a good friend who's the guitarist in that band.
What days, what nights are you there at Darwin's?
Well, the jam's on Wednesday.
Okay.
I think it starts at 8:30, but I generally get there late.
Wednesday night, 8:30, Darwin. Y'all be
yeah,
there.
It's a come, bring your instrument.
Is there a cover?
No.
No cover, okay.
And the food is good. Okay. But it's like, it's everyone is so cool. You know what mm-hmm. I mean? It's like you walk in and there's no one has ever gone up there and been like, oh, who are these people? You know what I mean? It's mm-hmm. all you just it's like family. Like
that's awesome. There. So you have you recorded at all?
I record in my dining room.
Everybody listen, all you producers out there, you're looking for a great voice, blues voice. This lady right here, she's ready.
You heard her. You saw her. Y'all holler at her, okay?
I would love to see her.
How do we get in touch with you?
I'm on Facebook, Rebekah Easley Ellis. Okay. And yeah, I guess that's probably the best way.
Best way to get in touch with you.
Did you know I don't answer my phone?
She's ready. She is ready. Rebekah Easley Ellis on Facebook. She's ready to record.
Her phone will be ringing.
Oh yeah.
It will be. It will be. So believe us. Your phone will be ringing.
What you think, Anthony?
Oh, he already told me. You know.
Call me, baby.
Right? He already knows.
He got connections.
What do we do?
Yeah. Well, and we are certainly going to push you.
Thank you.
You know, we are biggest fans.
And I can take it. I can take all the criticism because I'm telling you, it just makes me work.
This is your platform. So. This show provides a platform for artists like yourself to be on, to stand on. Mm-hmm. The world is yours.
And we appreciate it because I'm telling you, to go from like the quiet girl mm-hmm. who sings on the inside to be able to sing on the outside. And that song tonight, that I Put a Spell on You, I've mm-hmm. never sung that before.
Wow.
Like, except in the car.
I can't.
So you debuted that song first, here.
Yes, and I appreciate you guys letting me do that.
It was,
you know, yeah. That.
Wow.
That's what I'm talking
about. We appreciate
about.
That.
So you're ready. You are ready.
She's ready to do a lot more work.
Oh, yeah.
Recording.
Shows, club dates, and we're gonna help her do it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I appreciate it. It's so much fun.
You'll be seen by thousands and thousands of people.
Yeah.
Your phone will ring.
Well, Rebekah, will I get a date?
And you know what?
let's tie it back together.
I mean, yes, she's an artist.
I don't need any stalkers.
And her phone will ring, but you never know what can come out of the situation.
I'm gonna be playing Cupid. For this lady right here.
So Rebekah, when you land that date, that producer may say, hey, you know what that producer that called the other day? Well, we're going out.
How perfect would that be?
I know, right?
Great.
Right? Or somebody that can play the guitar.
Because we know a lot of people out there, especially her. She's like crazy. She's like very much...
magnet, yeah.
Yeah, everybody knows that.
We're going to have to just say, Rebekah, we love you. We got you.
Well, we got you.
We're going to be looking out, and we're going to get something recorded real soon.
That sounds so exciting.
And we're going to get that date.
Yeah, and we're going to see you. Actually, we're going to see you.
I'm more excited about that.
We're going to see you at Summer Jams, too. So.
Yes, definitely.
I mean, you never know who walk in at Summer Jams, mm-hmm. who you may meet.
And you did say you were going to do a duet with me.
I'm going.
You go.
Putting it out there. I'm going to do a duet with Rebekah. Whatever song that you decide that you want to do.
And I'm the Anthony S. old lady who keeps track. So I'll be like, you said.
It's on. I can't erase it. It's on
no,
film.
No, hold him to it.
Yes.
Hold me to it. No, I will be playing out there, but I will be doing a duet with Rebekah. So
you'll look
for that. It's going to happen.
Well, Rebekah, thank you so much for coming by.
Thank you for having me.
And we're going you will be back. You'll be back. She'll be back.
I appreciate it, you guys.
Uh-huh.
Maybe with her new beau.
Oh, what? My gosh. That's
you
great.
Never know. Some producer friend, like, big time, like, you know, hey, this is my beau. And he's a major producer.
As long as he can play the guitar or something, I'll be like, hey, boo, yay.
Okay.
But anyway, yes, thank you guys so much. You guys are a lot of fun.
Thank you.
This has been At Home with AJ, where vision...
and reality
come together. Say good night, Rebekah.
Good night, everybody.
Good night, everybody.
See you next time.